On Tuesday, November 21st, 2017, officials of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission visited the Asokoro residence of the former DSS boss, Itai Kwenyong, to pick him up in connection with funds which the DSS allegedly collected from the office of the embattled former National Security Advisor, retired Colonel Sambo Dasuki, before the 2015 general elections. There was drama as EFCC officials attempted to arrest the former DSS boss and the former boss of the National Intelligence Agency, Ayodele Oke. The tirades between sister security agents was heavily criticized by lawmakers, and the Senate set up an ad hoc committee to investigate the matter.
There exists an acrimony between the
presenting the findings from the investigation, the chairman of the committee discloses that there is acrimony between the chief executive officers of the EFCC, the DSS, and the NIA.
This lack of cooperation and cohesion is reflected at a secondary level, with EFCC and NSA belonging to one group and NIA and DSS belong to another group. Accordingly, the principle of esprit de corps appears to be lost between these two groups.
The committee also makes some recommendations to the Senate.
The President and Commander-in-Chief should investigate the matter with a view to ensuring that the interagency rivalry or public exhibition of envy is avoided at all costs.
However, the lack of cooperation between the security agencies is a source of worry for lawmakers.
The problem of killings, the problem of kidnapping, the problem of terrorism can never be resolved, will never be resolved. We are deceiving ourselves. Except there is cohesion, there is cooperation, there is integration among these sister security agencies.
In a related development, another lawmaker, Senator Eyinaya Abaribe, is dissatisfied with President Buhari's handling of the security challenges in the country, specifically the farmers and herdsmen clashes.
Mr. President, yesterday in London, the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Nigeria and the President of Nigeria said that these killings were as a result of the people who were trained by the late Muammar Gaddafi. When a commander-in-chief says that he cannot take care of invaders invading Nigeria, why is he still a commander-in-chief?
Since the beginning of 2018, the insecurity problems across the country has become a subject of discussion in the upper chamber, a pointer to the sensitivity of the matter.